Hey Luke here. Wanted to do a quick video on Windows Server 2025 Preview Edition, doing the installation using an answer file or an auto unattend file. If you're familiar with the channel, I did a previous video over using or creating an answer file using Windows Server 2022. This one is very similar. Actually, this one won't go into as much detail as that one did, so I'll put a link to that one if you're unfamiliar with the answer files. But there is an associated blog post with this that provides more details on how you can sign up for the Windows Insider program and download the ISO to get this inside of your sandbox so that you can start using it and start getting familiar with some of the features that Microsoft is releasing with this new server edition. So I'm going to go ahead and drop off the screen. And what I have pulled up here is the actual auto unattend file that I'll be sharing with you all. Again, the link is out on the blog post on my site, and I'll put a link to the blog post down in the description of this video. This one is basically a copy of the Windows Server 2022 auto unattend file with a few changes. For this one, I did need to use a product key, and the product key that I'm using works for Preview Edition. Again, there's this specific product key that's in the file right now is to be used with Standard Edition. Microsoft does provide another one that can be used with Data Center Edition. But if you change to Data Center, just remember that you'll need to change this image index, and I believe you would change this value to 4 to install Data Center with the desktop experience. Just real quick, if we scroll down, you'll see some of the specific settings, such as the computer name. The computer that you build using this file will default to Packer-Win 2025. It will use the Central Standard Time Zone, and then here again is the product key. Scroll down a bit more, and you'll notice that we're running several PowerShell scripts, and that's the so that we can set up WinRM and enable remoting, because I do use this in the course with Ansible, and I use it in my personal sandbox. Just so that I can install SQL Server and everything in an automated fashion and spin up multiple machines using Vagrant. So that's what these different scripts do. This one actually adds a firewall exception for port 5986. And then at the end, you'll notice that we restart the computer. By default, the administrator password is going to be Packer. Now you can change this to whatever meets your needs. But that's essentially the file that we're going to be using. And I'm also going to be using VMware Workstation Pro to kind of just show you how quickly I was surprised at how quickly Windows Server 2025 installs. So the first step is to place this auto unattend XML file onto a virtual floppy disk. So let's do that. I'm going to use a tool, then it's the same tool that I used in the 2022 video, which is called Win Image. Go ahead and open that up. And the next thing we're going to do is just click on File, click New. The defaults are okay, and click OK. And now we're going to actually inject our. Yes, we want to inject it. And then the next thing is we just want to save this file and change the save as type, change it to an virtual floppy image. Either one of these extensions will work. I'm just going to go with FLP, save it. And then you can go ahead and close out. The next step is to open up VMware Workstation. and we're going to create a new virtual machine. We're going to choose custom because we don't want VMware to automatically try to install based off of that ISO. So choose custom, click next. This is okay. And then I will make sure you have, I will install the operating system later. Click next. Version is going to be server 2022, just because 2025 isn't available just yet. And then just give it a name. I'm going to call mine WinSRV 2025 and click next. Make sure it's UEFI because that's what the answer file was built for. And then click next. Give it the number of processors. This is going to be based on your resources and your environment. And then I'm going to go with 8 gigs of memory. This is fine for the default. Next. And then I'm just going through here and then finish. So once you have it over here, go ahead and right click on it and go into settings. We want to add our floppy drive. And instead of auto detect, we're going to go out, browse out to where we created our image. Choose that, click on open. And then the next step is we need to specify the ISO. And you'll get this ISO when you sign up for the Windows Insider program and download the ISO. And that's what I'm choosing here. Click open and then okay. And now we're ready to go ahead and start this virtual machine. You'll need to just click anywhere in here and then press a key. And now it's going to go through the installation file and you shouldn't be prompted for any inputs. So we'll give this a few minutes. I believe the last time I tried this, it took just a little bit over 5 minutes, maybe 6 minutes, but we'll see. So these are the PowerShell scripts or statements that are running. Once it finishes this stage, it'll reboot, and then you'll be ready to install, if you're using VMware, VMware tools. All right, so the install has completed. I'm going to go ahead and click here just to install those tools, and we should see a prompt. And there it is. Go ahead and click that, and then run setup 64. There will be one more reboot, and then you should be ready to start using Server 2025, start looking into a lot of the new features. Again, there's a link to those features out on the blog post that you can get familiar with those. A lot of those are around Active Directory, some SMB changes, and then also there's a link to a video of Ignite. They discussed a lot of the features there as well. So we're going to go ahead and restart. My main goal with using the preview edition is just to see how well it works with SQL Server 2022. And then also I want to set up a few clusters. So it looks like we are ready to go. Let's go. There are some updates that are available after you install. So you can just open up the server manager, go to local server, and then click on Windows Update. And of course, if you want to change the default password and everything, you can certainly do that. But just check for updates. It'll download updates, and then you're ready to get started using the preview edition of Windows Server 2025. Let me know down in the comments if you found this helpful. Like and subscribe and all of that normal stuff. And of course, check out the blog posts if you'd like more details. Thanks a lot for watching.